Welcome to the Microsoft Theatre. My name is Astrid McLean and I'm here today to talk to you about Azure Advanced Threat Protection. So how many people have heard about Azure ATP? Ah, a few people, great. So we've got a few people that know, a few people that are new. I'll introduce you to, I'll show you a demo. We have all of 20 minutes, so this is the fast version of this. So Azure ATP as a service was released on March 1st, so we've been out for about 6 or 7 weeks, but we're not brand new. The service was built on a foundation of a product that we already had, which was Advanced Threat Analytics. So all of that knowledge, all of those detections, all of that security research we used in ATA has been built into Azure ATP. So let's talk about why it's required. So here is what a typical attack looks like in an environment. It starts with an attacker compromising a credential. It can do this through brute force, it can do this through a phishing attack, number of different ways. But once they've got a user credential, it can be anyone in your organization. It doesn't need to be one of your domain admins, it doesn't need to be a privileged user, because the attackers are clever. They will use that credential and they will move laterally through your environment. That means they will move between machines. They are collecting credentials. They're trying to get to your privileged users. Once they do that, they can get control of your domain. Once they have control of your domain, they can basically establish a permanent presence there, which means then they can impersonate anybody and steal your sensitive data. Scary stuff, but Azure ATP is there to help with the detections, to find those compromised credentials, look for those lateral movement paths, and look for the types of things that our attackers are doing in your environment before it causes any damage. So the question is, today in your environment, how do you find those compromised credentials? How do you know when someone's laterally moving through your environment? This is an attacker that's got a normal user ID, moving between machines and effectively changing their identity. So some of the lateral movement techniques that typically are used by attackers, things like pass the hash and pass the ticket. I don't need your password anymore. I can steal your password hash from the memory of a machine. I can steal your Kerberos ticket from an environment and use that to impersonate you somewhere else. Those are notoriously hard things to detect in an environment. Similarly, you've got a lot of logs out there, you've got rule-based systems. They're effective to a point. There's a lot of work and expertise that needs to go into calculating those detections, understanding what they mean. And that's how Azure ATP can help you. It's all about helping you to detect and investigate advanced attacks involving identities. So today, our main sensor is based on the Active Directory Domain Controller. We look at the network traffic and understand what's happening in your network so we can find these lateral movement techniques. We can see when a credential is being used inappropriately or not normally in your environment. And as we go forward, because we're hosted in Azure, we'll be able to collect to other cloud services as well. But I do want to step back a little bit and tell you about where Azure ATP fits into our Advanced Threat Protection family. So we have three Advanced Threat Protection products. So we start on the left with Office 365 ATP. That's looking at your emails, it's looking at attachments, it's looking at when people click on things because the main vector of attack. Around 80% of our attacks come in through email or come in through people clicking on things. And that's where Office 365 ATP can help you to help defend and help detect those. But that's not the only way people get in. People will browse to websites, they will click on things. We have attacks that come in through other mechanisms as well. And that's where Windows Defender ATP comes in. That's our endpoint security product. So it's looking at your endpoints. It's looking for malicious behavior. So not just signatures, but behaviors are on the endpoint to see if we see malicious behavior there. But again, that's looking at machines. What happens if I brute force an account and simply log onto your network and connect? And that's where Azure ATP comes in. So it's looking for some of the techniques that attackers use. It's looking at reconnaissance techniques. It's looking at lateral movement in your environment. And it's looking at the techniques that attackers use to gain control of your domain. And so all three of the ATP products work together. We share information, we allow you to move between them to help protect your environment end to end across that kill chain. So how does Azure ATP work? So it's not just about knowing what attacks are there. We use a number of techniques. So the first one is looking at behavioral analysis. So we're looking at the information on your network, we're looking at the network traffic, we're building a profile of the users and entities in your environment to determine what's normal behavior, what's not. We also understand what techniques that attackers use. We know there are reconnaissance techniques that attackers use. We know what lateral movement looks like. So it's a combination of those things where it's both machine learning and behavioral analysis, as well as known attack techniques, gives us the ability to give you very high fidelity detections that have a very low false positive rate. So you can focus on just what you need to look at. And so Azure Advanced Threat Protection, it's in real time. We're looking at the network traffic on your domain controllers. We're parsing that traffic as it's happening. We're sending that data to Azure to do the detections. So these are very real-time detections. These are not things that happened yesterday. These are the things that are happening now to try and catch the attackers as they're in your network. We've done a lot of work to reduce the number of false positives so your security analyst can focus on just the things that are most important. We also have an investigation component. So it's not just about the detections, it's also about having your security analysts have a mechanism to be able to investigate what's happening in the environment. And we do all this at scale. So because we are hosted in Azure, we can scale to the largest environments out there. But even for smaller environments, it helps with your deployment. It's a very easy component to install. You install the sensors on your domain controllers on premises, and we do all the detection in the cloud. You're not having to put extra infrastructure into your environment in order to do those detections. So it reduces the strain in your environment and allows us to scale. It also allows us to connect Azure ATP to other cloud services. The first thing that we've done there is we've established a connection to Windows Defender ATP. As you're investigating any of the Azure ATP detections, you can easily switch directly to Windows Defender ATP in context for that user or for that device, and you can continue your investigation and switch back without having to go and find another tool. Azure ATP is focused on making sure that your security analysts have a simple, fast attack timeline so they can see what's happening in the environment. It's just not a massive alerts. It's a simple timeline. We give you clear information about what the attack was, what the detection was, and what you can do about it as well. Gives you the information about who it affected, what it did, and how it happened. From an investigation point of view, we can also give you this profile timeline. So for every user, for every resource in your environment, you not only see the detections, you can see what happened before and after. You can see when the person logged on, what resource they accessed. So from an investigation point of view, it's easy to get a full timeline about what happened. And then we provide you some additional investigation tools like our lateral movement graph. Here we go into your environment and help build a picture of what an attacker could do. This is about finding an end user and the path based on who's logged on and who is an administrator on a machine and the path an attacker could take to get to your sensitive users. This gives you the ability to reduce the attack surface in your environment before anything happens. So what does all this look like? So here's my live demo environment, which is Azure Advanced Threat Protection, and here's my timeline. And here in my environment, I'm going to start at the bottom of the timeline and see if I can work out what the attacker did. First thing they do is some reconnaissance. So reconnaissance using DNS, they've tried to do a DNS query. In this case, you can see that that connection was refused. It doesn't mean it matter whether the attack was successful or it was a reconnaissance that failed. The fact that the attacker tried something says that something's happening in your environment, and I'm going to tell you about it. And so we have a number of detections that are based on reconnaissance. We know that attackers will go and do things like SMB session enumeration, where in this case, we tell you which accounts they've exposed by connecting to the domain controller, just listing the users that are connected to it. Every user has to connect for a group policy. It gives them information about the users and what machines they're connected from. And this will give you the information about who's been exposed. Similarly, reconnaissance using directory services, we can see that this particular attacker has gone to look for who are the members of the domain admins group, the enterprise admins group, so that we can see what's happening in the environment. But I'll jump to the one that kind of jumps out, which is the identity theft versus pass the ticket attack. Here we can see that clearly someone has been compromised. Somebody has used my domain admin's Kerberos ticket, used it on another machine, which means they've stolen their identity. When I have a look at the machine that came from, I can have a look at the machine, I can see a timeline. I can also see a link here to say that there are 3 Windows Defender ATP alerts open for that machine. So it's very easy from an investigation point of view to link directly to Windows Defender ATP, where I can see what's happened directly on that machine, and I'm easily able to connect back. But what I will share with you is we have a number of people logged onto this machine, and a feature that we're currently building, so this isn't the product yet, but we'll give you a sneak peek of what's there. As I look at each of these users, I can see that they've got an investigation priority. I can see that this particular user has a risk level for 45. But if I have a look at poor Ron Helpdesk, he's got a much higher risk level. So from an investigation point of view, this is probably a user I should investigate first and try and understand what's happening. And we give you information about why his risk level is so high. This is a help desk user that's suddenly connected to 40 different machines, all in a short period of time. From an investigation point of view, we're helping you to hone in on what it is that you need to do. And if I go back to my timeline, I can see what happened afterwards. I can see that there was a remote execution attempt. Somebody tried to connect to my domain controller and run something remotely. I can see there's the malicious replication. So one of the techniques that attackers use is they try and steal your Active Directory database. Any replication that is not from another domain controller is going to trigger this so we can see what's going on. And from one of our abnormal detections, we can see that this administrator has added someone to the admins group. So this is something they use to gain persistence. We don't alert on every change because your admins are doing that every day. But in this case, we've identified that it's an unusual change. This admin hasn't done anything for a long time and suddenly added something into the admins group. So we use that machine learning to really highlight the things that are most important. And then finally, in this environment, we can see that a golden ticket's been used. So this is as part of our inspection of the network traffic on your domain controllers. We're parsing all of the protocols to understand exactly what's happening with Kerberos, exactly what's happening with SMB. In this case, we can see that the Kerberos ticket that has been used has a lifetime which is greater than what should normally be in that environment. That's a clear indication that there's a golden ticket hack happening in your environment. So, this works again. All right. So I'm not going to go through all these detections, but Azure ATP has a large number of detections across the different components of the kill chain. So we're looking for reconnaissance. We're looking for compromised credentials. We're looking for those lateral movement, like the pass the hash, pass the ticket. We're looking for privilege escalation and those domain dominance, things like the golden tickets, silver tickets. Those are the sorts of things that we understand that attackers use, but you combine that with the machine learning, and we have a good set of detections that help you really understand what's happening in your environment without having to parse through thousands of alerts. So, why do you want to deploy Azure ATP? We're going to detect threats quickly with our behavior analysis. So I talked about the fact that it's real time, it's very easy to deploy. You create a workspace in Azure ATP, you deploy sensors to your domain controller, and you don't have to do any other setup. We're already going to start to generate detections on your behalf. Your security operations team can focus really on what's important with that simple attack timeline. They're not having to go through a massive alert. We're trying to highlight the things that are truly important to them. We've driven down that list of false positives. So there's a lot of work that's done in the detection engine to make sure that we're not just alerting with thousands of alerts. Because if you have 1,000 alerts, you may as well have none. The security operations team just can't cope with that sort of number. We're doing it at scale through Azure. So very little footprint on your on-premises, very easy to deploy, and it can cope with a very, very large scale. And of course, we always get information for our information security graph. So we're able to get new information out quickly. And from a deployment point of view, it's very easy to do updates. Just yesterday, we put out a blog post that talked about an update that we'd made into Azure ATP. We updated our pass the ticket attack to deal with a threat that was advertised by Preempt. So that addition to Azure ATP is already in the product just weeks after we found that vulnerability. The ability to update the service very quickly gives you an advantage. So that was a very quick version of Azure ATP. We do want to hear your feedback. We do want to talk to you if you want to join our Azure Advisors group, or we have two public communities as well for both Azure ATP and ATA. We've got more information in our documentation. If you want to trial Azure ATP, you can use the Enterprise Mobility and Security E5 trial, which will give you 3 months where you can try out Azure ATP in your environment. Or you can send us feedback through the AATP feedback at microsoft.com. And with that, if you want to fill out the survey, you're welcome. I've been told that we don't have any security blankets left. I'm really sorry. But if you have any questions, I'm happy to take them now, or I'll be around for the next little while to answer any questions you've got. And thank you very much for your time.